Computing Tianjin University for the paper entitled Enhanced Compiler Bug Isolation when Memorized Search. So,
hi, can you see my PPT? Okay.
Awesome. So,
okay. Well, hi everyone. My name is Hoyama. I'm going to talk about my paper titled Enhanced Compiler Bug Isolation via Memorized Search. And this work was finished by Professor Junjie Chen, me, and Professor Liming Zhang. Well, I'll first go with compiler bugs and their destructive effects. Compilers are fundamental to many software, such as operating system, web browsers, and many popular applications. However, the bugs contained in compilers may block the way of the supporting relationship. And it's very difficult for developers to find where the bugs are. To solve the problem, a new technique called Divi was proposed. Given a bug trigger program, Divi can mutate it into a passing mutated test program. And suppose we have many compiler files involving in the compilation of bug trigger program. The bug contained file may not involve in the compilation of passing mutated program. And we call this involvement as coverage. And this coverage can help us to isolate the bug and decrease the suspiciousness of this innocent compiler files. By the way, DB uses a local mutation strategy. For example, given a statement, DB can mutate it into this following statement. And this small scope mutation strategy has some strengths, which like easy to be implemented, but also has some weaknesses. For example, it has limited mutation space and limited influence on program structure. And program structure here has a tight relationship with optimization. And during optimization, many bugs may occur. Because of these weaknesses, DB has some effective issues. For example, using DB, developers still need to check about 15 innocent files on average. And about 62.5% bugs cannot be isolated after checking five most suspicious files. Well, to improve the situation, we propose RUCBI, and RUCBI involves a new mutation strategy called structural mutation. Here, example, figure A shows a bug triggered program, which fails during compilation. And by inserting a while loop into it, we can turn it into the program in figure B, which is a passing mutated test program. And to implement this, we have, after this mutation, we can only need to check about seven compiler files before we find a bug instead of checking 30 files using local mutation strategy. And to implement this, we have four structural mutation operators, like inserting branches, inserting loops, inserting go-to statements, and inserting function bodies, function calls. We call all of this the ready to be inserted as ingredients. And here is our structural mutation process. We should know that branches, loops, and function bodies, function calls are all difficult to build. So to make things simpler, we can extract them from developer-provided test programs. And then we build an ingredient pool. And we select our target ingredient from it and insert the target ingredient into the C test program after finding available locations for insertion. And then we perform the redeeming process because some variables contained in the ingredient may cause some bugs. And finally, we obtain our mutated test program. And here, example. Figure A shows a bug trigger program, and figure B shows the variable location for insertion marked by a small triangle. And figure C shows the mutated test program after inserting an if statement. And now we have some mutation operators, and we need to know how to judge whether a mutated test program is passing or not. So here comes our test oracles. we have two test articles. The first one is for crash bugs. The crash bug means the bug trigger program will crash under some optimization level during compilation. And the test article for it is after mutation, we will check whether or not the mutated test program still crash or not. And the other test article is run code bugs. And run code bug means the bug trigger program will output inconstantly under different optimization levels. And test article for it is after mutation, whether or not the mutated test program still output inconstantly or not. And now we have a complete test article and some mutation strategies, mutation operators. And we should know that not all operators are suitable for one specific situation. So how to choose it? And now comes our mutation operators selection strategy. Suppose we have a thinker who can randomly select one operator at the first round, and then he mutates the bug trigger program and goes into the next round. And in the next round, he can draw some experience from the first round and select the operator with more consideration. And the same things happened until he reaches the 1 hour limit. During this process, the thinker can select the operator more sensibly. And we implement the thinker and the thinking process with reinforcement learning. In reinforcement learning, we have an agent who acts like a thinker. And we have environment who is like a workshop, a workplace for the agent to perform his or her action. An agent has some states, and in one state, he can choose an action to perform. An environment will feedback a reward to evaluate this action. And besides, the environment will also return a new state for the agent to update his state. And in our paper, the state means the number of times that each mutation operator has been selected to generate passing test programs. And the action means choosing a mutation operator. Reward here is the key. It is defined by similarity and diversity. And now we come to our reward definition. This three formulas define both similarity and diversity. Now, to be sure, similarity represents how similar between the coverage of bug trigger program and mutated passing test programs. And diversity represents how diverse among all the coverages of the generated passing mutated test programs. And we believe similarity and diversity are sufficient to build the quality judge system of newly generated passing test programs. So here is our quality definition. It's the linear combination of similarity and diversity. And the improved quality is based on quality. And it is used to filter out some low efficiency passing test program. And our reward is built on improved quality. And it's not only considered the current improved quality, but also the historical ones. So is the history involved. That makes the reward badly influenced by some extreme values. And here is our reinforcement learning algorithm called A2C. And here is an overview of it. We have a state first, and now we can build an ANN, which is short for actor neural network. The role of it is to predict action probability distribution and select an action, and then to mutate the bug trigger program into a passing test program. An environment will help measure the passing test program and generate an actual reward. And then the action will flow into the CNN, which is short for critic neural network. And this network is used to predict the actual reward, which is the potential reward. And this two reward will go to advantage loss function, which is here. And it not only considers current reward, but also the future reward. And then this loss function flow into the update process by using this formula. And finally, the state will be updated and go into next round. Now, we have used our reinforcement learning algorithm to generate many passing test program, and the coverage information of this program will give us some hint to calculate the suspiciousness of each involved compiler files. So here's our suspiciousness analysis. We calculate the suspiciousness score of statement S by this formula, and by aggregation, we can calculate the score of F. And using this formula, we can generate a ranking list by using this score of F in descending order. And the bug contained file may stay at the top of the ranking list, and it will be easy for developers to find the bug. And now we've finished our technical part. We'll go to our experimental part. Here is our evaluation. We have collected 120 bugs from GCC bug repository and LLVM bug repository. And we have totally three measurement metrics, TOPWIN, MFR, and MAR. And to show the advantage and the functionality of each component of RugBee, we involve some techniques for comparison. The first one is RugBee MH, which is a new version of RugBee, which abandons all reinforcement learning part and involves Metropolis testing algorithm. And the second is RugBee RAND, which is a new version of RugBee, which drops out all reinforcement learning part, and RugBee filter, which has improved quality measurement on the basis of RugBee RAND, and Divi, the state of art bug evaluation technique. And here is the comparison. From this table, we can see that RugBee performs much better than Divi. About 23%, 58%, 78%, and 89% bugs can be isolated within top 1, top 5, top 10, and top 20 files. This is big progress. And here's our contributions of structural mutation. We compare RugBee MH and Divi. The only difference between these two techniques is Divi MH contains structural mutation strategy, but Divi does not. And the improvement of RugBee MH over Divi can prove our structural mutation strategy has its own advantage, and it can help improve the efficiency of RugBee. And here is a contribution of reinforcement learning strategy. We compare RugBee MH, and RugBee RAND. The improvements of RugBee over RugBee MH and RugBee over RugBee RAND can prove the role of reinforcement learning strategy. And we further study the contribution of it by drawing a widening plot and a box plot of GCC and LLVM box using RugBee, RugBee MH, and RugBee RAND. By comparing these three techniques, we find that reinforcement learning improves similarity. And we further draw a widening plot and box plot of diversity. And the RugBee has no advantage of diversity compared with the other two techniques. So we assume that diversity may contradict, a similarity may contradict diversity. And we have an assumption that reinforcement learning may enlarge diversity after maintaining a high similarity. And finally, is our contribution of quality measurement. We compare RugBee filter and RugBee RAND. The only difference between these two techniques is RugBee filter has a quality measurement, but RugBee RAND does not. An improvement shows the advantage of this quality measurement. And here's our summary. We first talk about the compiler bugs and their destructive effects. And then we mention our structural mutation strategy and our reinforcement learning algorithm called A2C. Finally, by comparing the RugBee and Divi, we can show that our technique is more efficient than the state-of-art bug isolation technique. And that's all. Thank you all for listening.
Yeah, awesome. So any question? You can raise your hand in the aisle. On mute. So any questions? So I can see if there is any question on the OVA app. Looks nothing. So I have a quick question, like, did you know about what kind of features are learned by the reinforcement learning to help you identify the structure of the why the program is more related to a bug or not, or programs are similar in terms of compiler optimization or whatsoever, things like this. Just any idea about this?
Well,
what kind of features are learned by the reinforcement learning? We know that
we
the
can
reinforcement
see this,
yeah.
We can see this overview. The thing is that our reinforcement learning learn is a linear combination of diversity and similarity. And we believe these two criteria is useful for isolated bug, because similarity can be used for aim at the specific bug, and diversity can help us generate more diverse passing test program. So I think these two criteria is the thing that our reinforcement learning tries to learn. And this criteria can help us isolate the bug.
Yeah, awesome. So any other one have question? You can raise your hand and I can unmute for you. If there, we still have time, so we can raise questions. Okay, so thank you very much, Haoyang, and can we move to the next speaker? So
okay, thank you.
Yeah, thanks. Can we have a setup? Yes, I think our next speaker